Hello and welcome back to the channel, everybody. My name is Dark Sage Walker, and one of my viewers on Discord has been trying to put together a build using, like, I'll just show it to you, but it's using the Chaos Arcana Mortal Coil, which, for those of you who aren't 100% sure, Scorpion Spear. And there's been a lot of questions as to how to get that to work properly. Now, as the inventor of the Ultra Combo setup, I think this is a pretty easy one. But I also think, hold on a minute. Pardon me. I also think that it can be difficult to get this to work right, as it, unlike with the Ultra Combo setup, not everything is necessarily... Not everything is necessarily melee, although with that, you are using Fiery Yo-Yo, so not everything is necessarily... Sorry, I just blanked. Not everything there is necessarily melee either. So let's try something different, actually. Let's go for a, like, power combo setup. Instead of worrying about the Dark Katana, we'll just worry about being strong. So for our... pardon me. Apparently I'm still sleepy. I apologize. I've been up for a couple hours and have been spending that time just kind of admittedly staring off into the middle distance, but let's see, do I run Tidal Blast? What sort of... I was thinking about running Radiant Knockout just because I find it to be fun. What else would be a... Fadeaway Rhythm could be fun. Like, there's lots of interesting, kind of powerful options that you could use. Shearing Chain is something that I brought up. Although I would run that more so for a... Apparently I'm not thinking well today, I apologize. I must still be very tired, but... Yeah, Shearing Chain I would run with a critical hit setup. So what do I run with a power setup? There's so many things that could actually work quite well. But I think what I'm gonna go with is I had two original ideas, the Crystalline Balestra and the Radiant Knockouts. And I'm not sure which one I wanna go with. So I'm just gonna take the Balestra. Now, do I run Air Spinner? I think for sake of this build, what I want to run is Spark Contact. Then we just need ourselves... See, I keep going back and forth. I keep changing my mind as to what I want to run. Razor Burst. Actually, I think what I want to run is Thunderline. And we've got ourselves a workable power combo. So now, do we enhance our power even further? Or do we reduce our cooldowns? As that has other implications as well. I think I'm going to go the usual route. Apparently I'm very tired today, so forgive me. Yeah, I thought I was, you know, more awake than this, but apparently my body said, nah. Ugh. Alright, you know what? Because everything is based around comboing, I think cooldown reduction is the name of the game here. And then, last thing before we start seeking our fortunes. Okay, that's jazz soundtracks three times in a row, so next run, I pick the music. Because apparently fate has decided that I should just run jazz soundtrack 24/7. Oh, come on, just give me my retro floor plan like I deserve. You know, for being a good boy. Okay, game is being difficult. In the meantime, I will say I hope you're all having a wonderful day today. I know I'm a sleepy boy, but that doesn't necessarily mean that you guys have to be. If you are, though, I understand. There we go. I don't even necessarily know why my body has just decided, alright, nap time. I bet it has to do with my sleep schedule, though. Alright, I think I want to start with the twins, and then we'll just see what happens after that. Alright, so clearly you can see what we have going on here. Now, one thing that probably would be nice to have is some form of ranged control. Like spark array or gale force alignment. One of those two things would be nice. What would also be nice is to be awake. I thought I was awake, but apparently my body has said that I'm not. Oh, hi. How are you? So this is going to be a tricky run to perform while I'm, you know, partially asleep. I missed. That's embarrassing. Oh, hello. See, the one thing that I'm really liking about Mortal Coil is just how fast the cooldown is, and I figured with the speedy cooldown of Mortal Coil, we could make that work and be able to use it more frequently. More combos, after all, equals more damage. More damage equals dead magical constructs. And dead magical constructs equals a happier, healthier me. You know, in case for some reason any of you had to question how that was going to work. Okay, we can upgrade Thunderline, which is a good thing. And I think Frost Scimitar is definitely the way to go here. Hello. Wanderer's Mechanism and Thing I Don't Want. Perfect! I always wanted a thing I don't want.
Dark Sage, that doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, well, I didn't come here to make sense, I came here to play a game. Fans of Saw right now are going, is he gonna elaborate on the game? And I am not, because I'm not Jigsaw. Barry, if you want that kind of game, then you came to the wrong place. Yeah, okay. Oh, that's a bit of a waste of a signature charge, but that's okay. Owie. Okay, that room hurt a little bit more than I wanted it to. So when I said earlier that I was staring off into the middle distance, that was only partially true. What I was also doing was contemplating if there are any game series that I want to return to. Because I've been noticing that I've just been putting out mostly Wizard of Legend and 20 Minutes Till Dawn content, which I love both games, don't get me wrong. But there's also something to be said for, you know, variety of content. So I was also looking over things going, okay, what? I need something to play for the channel that, you know, people will dig. And admittedly, I have a few options brought about by suggestions in my Discord. Yeah, we'll go ahead and do that. Then we'll grab the Ballester upgrade. Namely, there are some people who are interested in Ember Knights. Some people who aren't, to be fair. I know I had a suggestion to do Blasphemous, which I'm not against, although my channel is more about roguelike games, but I have no problem doing a Metroidvania. Hell, for a while I was doing Hollow Knight content. But there are also other content creators who are much better at doing Hollow Knight content than I am. So I guess that's one of those things where it's like, I'm interested, but is there anything new I can bring to the table? And that's part of the reason why I'm enjoying doing 20 Minutes Till Dawn content, because I feel there is something new I can bring to the table. That's mostly just because there aren't a lot of 20 Minutes Till Dawn content creators out there right now. So as I'm learning more and more about 20 Minutes Till Dawn, I want to, you know, play and give you guys more fun things to look forward to. you know, new builds to try, new ideas to capitalize upon, and recently a new character. Nice. Thank you, Thunderline. No magnetic follow-up for this run. Now, on the point of the blasphemous request, I was also asking, did they want me to do just the original Blasphemous or Blasphemous 2, now that that's a thing? Okay, I'm getting embarrassingly destroyed by these enemies here. I mean, that's a maybe. Alright, sweet, that worked out. Other games that I was looking into. I don't want to change my basic. Okay, thanks. Thanks, control pad, that's exactly what I wanted. Okay, I'm getting tired of this. Sometimes all it takes is one room just to ruin your entire groove. And we're still looking for Iris. I suppose what I'm building up to with all of this is the question of what sort of content are you guys interested in seeing? Because I've played a lot of games for this channel, and there is any number of them that I would not mind returning to. Okay, so I'm gonna grab this specifically for this level. Could help a lot, and I'm hoping it does. Like, I've been thinking about picking up Binding of Isaac again. At the time when I was doing Binding of Isaac content, I had originally stopped because, again, there's so many other content creators out there doing Binding of Isaac content better than I could do it. But I haven't seen them putting out a lot of content for that game lately, and I do wonder if there's a reason for that, or if they've just moved on to other things. Like, I don't know. I really don't. But again, I'm only thinking of two creators. I know there's more people than that do Binding of Isaac. Hello, Mimic. Okay, we may very well have... We may very well have something on our hands here with this one. Oh, thanks, Burn Cycle. That's exactly what I wanted. See, another game that I had been playing on the channel for a while is Cult of the Lamb, which I was really enjoying, especially since I got to make countless Spaceballs references while playing that one. I don't know if that's something I want to return to or not, because, again, this is something where I think there are other content creators out there who are doing a fine job with that game. One thing I'm not trying to do is I'm not trying to step on anyone's toes. But if there's something you guys think that I can bring to the table, be it some knowledge of a game or, you know, my charming yet self-deprecating personality, by all means, I would like to hear it. Another one is 30XX, and what I was doing with that game is I was working towards getting the true ending. The thing about getting the true ending in that game is that it feels more like just a series of challenge runs instead of, like, anything really secretive. Mid-air kill. Okay, I don't want to give that up. That would just be silly. However, what I am going to do is I'm going to buy that. Then, let's see. Buy that. Alright, everything I'm planning on keeping, I drop here. So we drop that, and drop that. Alright, now let's go pick up our adorable mimic. Go grab all of our other stuff. Alright, so Adorable Mimic is at plus 25. Not the greatest thing in the world, especially since I have... since I have people in my Discord who are regularly getting the Adorable Mimic up to like plus 40 or plus 50. But I also wonder how much of that is them just sacrificing literally everything they have and not keeping anything. Could also just be trusting to luck. Because there is more to a successful run than just one relic. Ah, nuts. There we go. And actually, because I've been like waiting to do 30XX until I've been ready to do these challenge runs, I actually haven't been playing the game at all. Which I feel is a bit of a mistake on my behalf, because I love that game. But I haven't been playing it because I've been trying to wait to produce content for it. And now I feel like I've turned my back on an old friend. Get over here. It's like Scorpion if you were overly polite.
Come here, please!
Okay, so burn cycle is not something that you just arbitrarily use. It has to pretty much be the end of a combo. Because you end up jumping back to your original spot. I should take the portal. Come on, brain. We know these things. Take that because it doesn't involve movement that just tosses you around and makes it harder to combo. Look, memory chainmail is back. Why not? It's like we never lost anything in the first place. Got anything good for me? Kind of. I do like Aegis Charge. Aegis Charge, or however you guys want me to pronounce it. I keep bringing that up because I've been made fun of for the way I pronounced that word before, and yes, it's a little childish, but I can't help but keep thinking back to that and going, is there something wrong with me? Am I trying too hard? I don't know, guys. Help me out here. Is it me? Am I going too hard? Am I trying too hard to be smart? Or is this me thinking that there's something wrong with me when in reality there's nothing wrong with putting a little bit of intelligence and compassionate and things you care about. I don't know, I'm severely overthinking this because I... Pardon me, because I catch so much flack for small things. And yes, that does go up to and including my choice of music. Which, actually, I just got made fun of by someone for... at my job for. Like, I don't often talk about bad things that happen at my job, because genuinely, there aren't many of those. But I'll be damned if it didn't happen to me one day, because... Admittedly, it was kind of my fault. I was coming into work just listening to music on my phone out loud because I was just stepping out of my car and getting ready for my day, and I was like, you know what? I want some spirit box at the start of my work day. So I'm listening to it in the break room where we're clocking in, and one of my coworkers is listening to it, and she's got that look on her face. You know that look of there's a turd on the table, but I don't want to say anything about it. You know, that look. And she seriously looks at me and, no shit, just gives this dead ass, is that music? And I had to stop and go, bitch, have you never heard of metal before? Have you never listened to anything that wasn't like, you know, the most easy listening stuff in the world? Have you never had any sort of desire to listen to anything other than mainstream? I didn't say any of that though, because that's the sort of thing that gets a fella into trouble. So I responded to her politely. But what I wanted to do was slap the shit out that bitch. It's like, are we in part of a high school clique here? I thought we were supposed to be adults. Like, I'm not going to sit here and talk shit about you for music that I don't like. But apparently you think it's okay to talk shit about music that you don't like. Okay, that room was nuts, but only because of the summoners. Like, I don't expect you guys to, on that point, I don't expect anyone to just love my music. Like, I'm aware that that hard rock and metal are not for everyone. And whereas I would like people to be a bit more open-minded and easygoing when it comes to trying new forms of music, I'm not going to sit here and tell someone that they're a fool for not liking what I like, because that's not how the world works. But then on the same token, don't do that to me. Like, if I'm willing to be the bigger person and understand that not everyone is going to have the same feelings on everything as I do, then maybe you should give the same consideration to me and stop being a childish shithead. That's really all I have to say on that, and hopefully you guys at least have some understanding of where I'm coming from on that. And back to full. Ow. You, come over here. Alright, things are working out nicely. Oh. I wasn't aware that I had a full suite. Owie.
Whee!
Good fight. And that is the run. So the whole reason I brought up that whole list of games that I've been thinking about and ideas that I've been pondering is because I want to hear from you guys now. What games are you interested in seeing me play on the channel, or what sorts of other content would you be interested in? For what it's worth, I've really been going back and forth on things like, should I do some Reddit content? Should I go back to some old school YouTube and read creepypastas? Like, there are other creators out there that do that so much better than I do that I don't think it would be worth it. But I'm interested in hearing what you guys have to say. I am just being open to ideas right now. So I would like to hear from you guys what ideas you think would be most interesting for the channel and for your own personal entertainment. You know, what games are you interested in? What content do you want to see? What sorts of stories are you interested in? I already know that I have people on my channel that are interested in my D&D stories. And yes, I'm interested in telling those too, so those will be coming. I actually did almost an entire episode about a character just the other day, so hey, go ahead and check that out. But let me stop myself there because I'm rambling at this point. I want to thank you guys for coming and spending some of your free time here with me today. It really does mean a lot to me. I hope you're all having a fantastic day or night wherever you may happen to be, and I will catch you in the next one. My name is Dark Sage Walker, and you take care, everybody.